By way of announcements, what do we have happening? I think there's something on at 1 o'clock, right?
And praise God for the beautiful day again. You want me hot chocolate or blanket? Thank God for the beautiful day.
Looking forward to temperature.
That's tradition.
More announcements.
Arms party, Saturday night.
I think she's at a coffee.
They missed the center. Everybody is invited to come out. Jess and Lori are in charge of the games. Ladies Ministry is providing the rolls, the sloppy joes, the hot dogs, condiments, those things. If your last name begins with an A through L, bring a side dish. If you're M through Z, bring a dessert. There will also be a silent auction that Tawana is cutting up. Proceeds of that will go to the ladies' ministry.
And if you have something for that silent auction, we'd like to have it in today, right, Tawana?
Yeah, at least by Wednesday.
At least by Wednesday. It's going to give you a little grace period. At least by Wednesday, so it's not too late to get something in for the silent auction.
Also, if anyone has not got the new yellow church directory, they're in the back or see me. I tried to put them in once in a while, so if I miss anybody, the new directory is here.
Yeah. Or if you lost yours already.
We're not pointing fingers, are we? I don't know.
The preacher lost his.
Also, the shoebox packing party will be November 13th, so if you want to help pack shoeboxes after church that Sunday, bring a lunch for you and your family, and then afterwards we'll be packing 120 plus shoeboxes.
I am trying to get an idea about Christmas, as bad as it's creeping up on us. I'm not ready for the snow, but Christmas dinner party, like we always had, I'm trying to get an idea of how many would be interested in doing it again this year.
All right.
So.
Monday, November 14th is ladies' luncheon at Haas's. If you could let me know, I'd appreciate it.
All right. Oh, Julia.
I hear you're trading this.
Somewhere. Also, we just did some remodeling in all the restrooms. If you haven't been in there yet, all the facilities have been changed, and also the ceiling tiles have all been redone, repainted in the ministry center. So it's really bright and white. So we didn't get the disclaimer up yet. If you happen to see some new gray hairs you didn't see before, it's because the trustees made it whiter and brighter in there. So we're sorry for that. Just shut your eyes when you go in.
Speaking for the announcements. It's time for Usher to come forward. We're waiting on you for the morning tithes and offerings.
Father God, we thank you for this opportunity we have to come join together with all the Christians, Lord. We just ask that you would be with us through the service, Lord. We ask that you give this offering for the gift and giver and for the upcoming year. In Jesus' name, we pray.
Thought she was being that little boy. Thought she was being that little boy.
Oh, okay.
See your husband?
Yes, he was.
How long ago did he die?
About 2 weeks now, but he was never really mine.
Oh, yeah?
He was a pastor.
Oh. I see.
Mamas, don't let
let your babies grow up to be pastors. Pastors are easy to love, but they're hard to get home. Just one more call to be made, the seed to be sown.
Long-winded blessings and old illustrations, everyone thinks he's a saint. His wife, yeah, she loves him, and she goes home with him, but that's one thing she knows he ain't.
Moms, don't let your babies grow up to be modern day language. Yeah, they'd rather get out their Bible, speak from the Greek.
Dinner is burning, but he keeps on preaching, then stops to shake every hand. He ain't worried about eating, cause he keeps on dreaming.
Children's up here.
Give it some kids coming up. Oh, yeah.
Okay, I never did.
Get all the kids up here.
Anybody know what these are?
Crutches? What do you think they are?
Crutches.
What do you think they are?
Crutches.
Okay, I guess it's agreed then. What are they for? I thought that was for reaching out to get kids. They're not for that? Or they're not for cleaning the lights when you can't reach it, you get this cobweb webs with them? Okay. Have you ever used crutches? Have you ever been on crutches? You ever had a family member that was on them? You have? Okay. So what was they on them for? You use them like this? Ankle sprain, okay. Ankle sprain, so what good does this do with your ankle? You put your ankle on this? How does it help with them?
It helps you stand.
Helps you stand with your ankle. So how does it help you stand with your ankle? You have to lean on them, don't you? Any way they work is if you lean on them. And so you can take your weight off your ankle or your knee or whatever it is that's going on. We've been created by God to lean to. We were never made to do everything by ourselves. We weren't made to be the Lone Ranger. We weren't made to do it by ourselves. So when it comes to learning and education, who do you lean on? Who helps you learn stuff?
Teacher.
Teacher? God. There's another one. Who else helps you learn? They live with you in your house. Squirrels? That's what lives in our house. Your parents. Your parents help you to learn. And so you lean on your parents. When you're growing up, you lean on your parents. I mean, how many of you guys pay your own bills? Do you pay rent? Okay. Do you pay for your food? Okay. Then you're leaning on your parents then right now, right? Do they have to provide you? How many buy your own clothes? You go out and buy your own clothes with your own money? Your shoes? Okay. So we lean on our parents a lot for those things. And we when we come to church, we lean on our church family to teach us about God and our teachers there. And so all throughout life, we have to lean. And we're made to lean. Jesus said in Matthew 10:28, he says, "Come unto me, all you who are weary and heavy burdened or heavy laden, and I will give you rest." In other words, he's saying, you can come and lean on me. Jesus says, come lean on me. If you learn to lean on me, take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly of heart, and you will find rest for your souls. Jesus is the one we can really lean on. He helps us through whatever we go through. If we're having a hard day, we say, Jesus, help me. Or somebody's bothering us at school, Lord, help me. Help them not to bother me. Help me to get this test done. We can lean on him throughout our day just by simply saying, Jesus, help me. And so we have to learn to lean. So we're going to have prayer, and then we have a little song about leaning, and then you can hit up Becky for something good, okay? Heavenly Father, we pray that you'd help the young people to learn to lean on you, and no matter what they're going through, they can just whisper a quick prayer and ask you for help, that you'll be there with them. Help them, Lord, to know they can't go by themselves, but they need to learn to lean on you. We ask in Jesus' name.
Tell me whose side are you leaning on? Are you leaning on the Lord's side? Tell me whose side are you leaning on? Are you leaning on the Lord's side? I lean, I lean, I lean, I lean. I'm leaning on the Lord's side. I lean. I mean, I mean, I mean, I'm leaning on the Lord's side. I mean, I mean, I mean, I mean, I'm leaning on the Lord's side. I mean, I mean, I mean, I mean, I'm leaning on the Lord's side.
For you right there behind you. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding.
Through it all.
Through it all, I learned to
know, we can, well, we can sing along, hum along.